Good morning, and I would like to welcome everyone to the 12th meeting of the Standards, Procedure and Public Appointments Committee in 2022. I would remind those attending virtually to place an hour on the chat function of BlueJeans should they wish to raise any issues. Our first agenda item is for the committee to agree to take agenda item 5 in private. Agenda item 5 is the ongoing consideration of the evidence heard in relation to our inquiry into future parliamentary procedures and practices. Are members in agreement with that? Excellent. Thank you very much. Our second item is for the committee to consider an application for recognition of a proposed cross-party group on heart and circulatory diseases. And can I welcome Colin Smith, MSP, to the meeting? And Colin is one of the proposed co-conveners of the proposed group. Colin, would you like to make an opening statement about the intentions of the CPG, please?
Thank you very much, convener, and thank you to the committee for the opportunity to outline this application for the group. A CPG for heart disease and stroke existed in previous parliaments, and I had the privilege of being the co-convener during the last parliament. I'm proud of the groundbreaking work the group undertook, including two major inquiries, one on atrial fibrillation and the other on hypertension, and many of our recommendations are now being taken forward. We took some time to consider the focus of any such CPG in this parliament and how we can best build on the achievements of the previous group, which is why the request to establish this group is maybe slightly later at the start of the new parliament. In discussion with colleagues, we decided to have a proposed cross-party group that focused on heart disease and circulatory diseases, given the scale of the issues, rather than try to cover two major conditions. We know that while there's been considerable decline in mortality rates due to advances in the treatment of acute cardiac disease, sadly, coronary heart disease remains Scotland's biggest killer. But conscious that there are many cross-party groups, the approach we want to take in this parliament is, yes, very much focus on heart disease and some very specific work, for example, on issues relating to out-of-hospital cardiac arrest. But we also want to carry out some more cross-working with other CPGs. So, for example, one major issue we want to consider is the sex-based inequalities in the detection, diagnosis and treatment of heart disease and how we monitor the government's Women's Health Plan in relation to heart disease specifically. That's an area that would lend itself to joint working with, for example, the cross-party group on women's health. There's been considerable interest from MSPs in the proposed new group, and we have three co-conveners from three different parties. And if the group is given the go-ahead, the next step will be for ourselves and stakeholders to circulate details of the group, which it was a previous case, and we anticipate a significant interest, in particular from individuals who are living with heart conditions. And that was an important group within the previous CPGs, and they influenced our work considerably. So I'll leave it at that, convener, but obviously open to your questions.
That's very kind of you. Do any committee members have any questions? Edward, can I come to you first, and then I'll come to Colette. Edward.
Okay, thank you, convener. Colin, you said working across other cross-party groups. Do you see that as just being correspondence, or do you see on certain areas having joint meetings so that people can share and build on the experiences that they're bringing to those meetings?
We're very keen to have joint meetings and even joint pieces of work. So I mentioned that the previous group did two major inquiries. We were very clear that the issues that we face, whether it could be air pollution, so that lends itself to looking at working with cross-party groups to deal with active travel, or, as I mentioned earlier, women's health issues, which there is a very specific problem in terms of detection rates of heart disease within women. I think we want to look at having, at the very least, meetings, joint meetings with other cross-party groups, but ideally possibly even some joint work on particular issues, but obviously that would require discussion with those groups.
Okay, thanks, convener. I'm heartened to hear that, because I think sometimes cross-party groups can work independently where there are areas of ground they can work together, and I'm glad one of the conveners is working towards that. So thank you, Colin.
Thank you, Edward. Colette, and then Bob.
Yeah, thanks very much, convener. And it was really just... It's very welcoming to hear that you're resurrecting the cross-party group again. And one of the things I actually went to visit recently was a business in my constituency called Low Salt. And one of the things that you're trying to target from UK and Scotland is how we try to reduce our salt, because we often talk about sugar. So I'm just wondering if that's something that you would consider looking at. I know they've changed the guidelines on it so that it would need to be down to 5 grams. And I think at the moment, most people, our intake is 9 grams.
Yeah, absolutely. And I've learned something new today already. But I think one of the important things about the cross-party group is that what we ask for is obviously ideas for work that we carry out and we circulate that, particularly, I think, from people who are maybe living with conditions. So I think that's a really important issue, and I'll take a note of that. And we're really keen for people because we know this impacts on all your constituents. It is, sadly, heart disease, the biggest killer in Scotland. We want to hear people's ideas of what work we need to carry out, because there's a lot of important issues out there that I think lends itself to this particular group.
Thank you. Thanks very much, Colin.
Thank you, Colette. It is fascinating how often members of this committee suggest ideas for CPGs that come before us, but maybe that's the privilege of overseeing them.
That's not a requirement for it to be approved, is it, from Colette, that they take forward the idea.
We'll see if she notes an interest in a moment. Do you want to come in? Yes. Just going to pass over to Bob.
Convener, I think my blushes have just been spared, but it does allow me to put on the record. I'll explain why, Mr. Smith. First of all, thank you for bringing this cross-party group forward. The initial papers I had no individuals or organisation listed as being members of the group, and I was going to ask why that was the case, but the Clarkin team have just furnished with a really outstandingly impressive list of stakeholders. So I'm very pleased to see that. I'll just put that on the record. It's good to see that you're reaching out to all the relevant individuals and groups. I was going to ask why there was no organisations represented, but it's a really impressive list. So just wanted to kind of put that on the record, Convener.
It would be to obviously circulate details more widely, and we anticipate that a lot of individuals will be interested in joining us. Say that important group of people living with conditions, and we're keen to have them at our meetings and support our work.
Thank you, Colin. If there are no more questions, absolutely. Apologies, Tess.
Thank you, Convener. Could you just explain how you propose to act as a channel of communications between people affected, the health professionals, and the research community? So each of those three are quite individual stakeholders. Thank you.
I think, first of all, to ensure that we have representation on the group from all those stakeholders, and that was certainly the case with the previous cross-party groups. We had people involved in research, health professionals, and, as I say, importantly, people living with conditions all attending our groups. When we carried out the two inquiries on atrial fibrillation and hypertension in the last Parliament, we did a lot of roundtable work involving those groups, quite extensive work involving those groups, inviting them to give evidence to the committee so we can learn from them. So that'll be a really important factor. If you look at the list of extensive list, as Ms. Doris said, of organisations, they represent a lot of those stakeholders that you highlighted.
Great, thank you.
Thank you, Tess. Thank you very much for attending this morning, Colin. The committee will consider whether to approve the application for recognition at the next agenda item, and clerks will inform you of the committee's decision in due course. Thank you for attending today. And agenda item 3 is indeed whether or not we wish to extend approval for this cross-party group for heart and circulatory diseases. Do any members have any comments? Or can I invite us to agree recognition? I'm very grateful. Agenda item 4 is a stage 2 proceedings on the Scottish Local Government Elections Candidacy Rights of Foreign Nationals Bill. And can I welcome George Adam, Minister for Parliamentary Business of the Scottish Government, who is joining us today remotely, along with his accompanying officials. I highlight the fact that officials are not to speak on the record during these formal proceedings. No amendments have been lodged for this stage, so the only requirement is to agree the four sections of the bill and its long title. But before doing this, can I thank George Adam for attending today and invite the Minister whether he wishes to make any comments at this stage, or is happy for the evidence that he sent us in the form of a letter and the early evidence given to this committee to stand as the official record of the government's position. George.
Thank you, Convener. And if you'll indulge me, I'll make a very brief statement on the Scottish Local Government Elections Candidacy Rights of Foreign Nationals Bill. As members will recall, this is a very limited single-purpose bill, and it seeks to ensure compliance with treaties that the UK Government has agreed in relation to candidacy rights in local government elections. I welcome the Scottish Parliament's unanimous support of the bill at stage one and the committee's ongoing scrutiny of the bill. And as no amendments have been lodged for consideration at stage two, convener, I have nothing further to add.
I'm very grateful to that, George. Before I actually take the formal vote, do any committee members have any questions on the procedure to follow before we move that? Edward.
Not on the procedure. Can I ask a question of the minister?
For you to ask a question, and then I will see whether or not I'll invite the minister to respond, Edward.
It's just when we did the stage one and we took evidence from the minister said that he would be bringing forward an amendment at stage two, which he hasn't done. And I would be grateful to understand what his rationale for not doing what he said he was going to do. I'm sure there's a perfectly good reason, but I would like the minister to explain that to us.
Well, certainly the minister has written to the committee. And that letter stands in evidence, which explains the position. But I'm more than happy, George, if you'd like the opportunity to explain the anomaly, let me call it that.
There is nothing really to add to the letter that's already available, convener, apart from the fact that it was our intention to bring that amendment forward, but in discussions with UK government, we found that it would create problems and difficulties on their side as opposed to our side, and they didn't see it themselves as a problem. So rather than have an argument with the UK government over something that neither of us really saw was as a serious problem, we decided it was best not to bring the amendment forward at this stage. I hope that's a simple summary of the position.
Are you content, Edward?
I'm content for that to be on the record and the fact that there was no argument required. Thank you.
I'm grateful. I'll now move to the formal element, which is that the question is that sections 1 to 4 be agreed to. Are we all agreed?
Agreed?
Yes, we are agreed. And the question is that the long title be agreed to. Are we all agreed?
Agreed.
That ends stage 2 consideration of the bill. And can I thank the Minister for attending today and his officials? The next item, the next thing, is to move the meeting into private for consideration of agenda item 5. I therefore close the public element of this meeting.